Hey folks, DC7 here. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to Watt's Farm. So, I've finished cutting all the grass in this, well, all the grass. This isn't exactly a giant field, but I have finished cutting the grass here. And now, I'm attempting to windrow it into findable piles. Yeah, this, the grass is a little bit weird on this map. It's not easy to deal with, let's just say that. Nice and close. Now we can get in a little snugger than that. Right about there. Yeah, I've changed this old McCormick up a little bit. I got rid of the twin wheels and threw a set of wheel weights in it. Kind of like that a little better, I think. I'm going to do the same thing we kind of did with the annoying part of it. I'm just going to do circles and keep pushing it closer to the center and closer to the center. And the theory is, eventually, we should have all of our grass up the middle. Thing is, I don't know if this... It doesn't have that piece on the end that kind of packs nice tight rows, so I'm not sure if this isn't maybe just sort of, you know, flinging it in a direction as opposed to actually windrowing it. Because it is, says say it's a rake, it doesn't anywhere in there say that it's a windrow, a windrower, whatever you'd like to call them. So, this is... little bit of the experiment, and we'll see how this goes. This is another thing that makes it difficult on here is where these piles are, and then you'll notice there's no row here for quite a while. Yeah, but it was doing that, if I recall. We were also seeing that same behavior doing straw windrows. I believe the harvester was doing the same thing, wasn't it? That may have been another map, but I sort of recall that. It would go along and nothing, and then woof, a 6 foot high hill of straw. And then, same thing, nothing. Yeah. So. Well, this certainly isn't going to take as long as the cutting, I'll give it that. It seems to be working. I can see things are gradually getting cleaner toward the edges and messier towards the middle. And, well, I guess that's what raking is all about. Now, it has been a little bit since we've done Old Ridge, and I have decided, I mentioned it before, and then I did another episode just to keep up with things on the farm. But I've kind of been avoiding doing it because it's still not available for all you guys to play with. And that's kind of how a Let's Play works, is we all get to, you know, jump on a thing and do something with it. So... yeah. I do keep checking back, because from what I understand, it's modding central. It's going to be released on, of course. And, it's still not there. So, as I said, we're gonna play about here on Watts, and, which is okay. It's a good way for us to learn the Seasons mod. And then when, This does look like it's going to reduce it all to pretty much a runaway. Well, it's certainly going to make the loading wagon bit of this real easy. So yeah, and then when the map is released, we'll carry on from there, right? Well, it does seem to make rows. It's beyond me how it manages, but it does seem to be able to manage it. Okay, we'll have one row to pick up. boy. Sort of. Alrighty, there. Well, that's pretty funny. Oh, this doesn't actually lift off. It just disengages the wheel from the actual bars. And away we go. Alright, well, that wasn't too fierce, was it? That was actually a pretty quick job. Oh, I meant... Oh. To not press that. I actually meant to press this. I've never pressed the 5 key before. No, I was running on single time. As I was... doing a little bit of wandering around here, looking at a few different things and figuring some stuff out. But, what did I figure out? Not much, believe me. Not too much. I don't see... Ah, there they are. Hello, the mountain pigs! Living in the mountains, we got logs floating in the air. It's a good day on the farm. Alright, I keep this over by the coo barn. Of course, now with a wee bit of grass, it makes me ponder the question, why don't I have a wee bit of sheep? I think we have everything else we need except the woolly crunchies themselves. Da-da. I think steers weird because it also pushes as much as it steers. So you kind of combination of sliding it and steering it. Alright, let's get you undone. Thank you. And I suppose since we're already in this thing, we might as well run it down and grab the forage wagon. Providing it's still upright. Pretty rusty, man. You know, you think if you go to sell something, you'd at least throw a coat of cheap paint on it. A little bit of Tremclad or something, you know. But, no, it was wear is as is. So. She's no beauty, but she's guaranteed it works. Hopefully. There won't be any issues with it. Euroboss. Well, you don't look so much like anybody's boss anymore, I'm afraid. Jeez. It's almost mismatched a little, eh? And let's hook up the hoop-de-doop. Well, so far, so good. I don't see anything telling me she ain't gonna work. And although we do have a silo, I don't imagine we're gonna have a whole bunch left. By the time we put the sheepies in and dump the rest into the cow troughs, I mean, I know we don't have any cows yet, but I would assume once something's in a trough, it doesn't rot. Yes, we're gonna beat the system one way or the other. First, we gotta have some grass in the bucket. And I'd like to do this before the sun goes down. Whoa. Well. It certainly rattled the cap off my head, let me tell you. Oh, I'm at 3 here. This is just getting ridiculous. Oh, yeah. What have we done? What have we done? I was trying to avoid driving on the field. Good job, eh? Good job. At least we know this isn't going to take long. We just got to find our row. There it is. Yeah, I might have got a little carried away with the old rake. I'll admit it. Alright, ooh. Well. Go, baby, go. They're coming up to speed. Well. It ain't gonna be much, but it is what it is. Just over 5,000 liters, that's not bad. I'm closer to 6, actually. 6,700 liter of grass. Well. Get the rest of that, there we go. Okay. That's a... 20 after 7. It's supposed to be another nice day tomorrow, but we are just about done for today, I gotta tell you. In fact, I think, just so we can finish the rest of this episode with a little bit of ambient light, I'm going to quickly kick her back down to 1x for the trip home. Amazing how complacent someone can get about something as amazing as, messing with the flow of time. No problem here. We'll just slow her down. No, we'll just go 5 times the speed. Yeah. You thought Minecraft let you play God. I was having a discussion one day. My brother doesn't play Minecraft. He's a little bit of a video gamer. He used to be. Time constraints is sort of removed most of that from his hobby life. I have a fact he doesn't have a computer right now. But, he's never played Minecraft, and I was explaining to him some of the odder points of it. And not really the odd points of Minecraft, but the odd points of how people have decided how Minecraft works. You know? Like, it's really a way to tell that, what's in human nature to do Really? By looking at a lot of what goes on in Minecraft, you know, you have villagers who you can basically stuff into little pens, you know what I mean, and actually make a slave colony out of it. Where you stick them in pens, you're not responsible for their welfare. If they don't have the item you want to buy, you simply kill them off and replace them with another villager. You know, I started explaining all of these things and he goes, but my kids play Minecraft. I'm like, yeah, dude, it's, like I said, it is what you make of it, you know. But yeah, we got a little bit of weirdness. Alright, let's get some of this dumped into the cow trough, and then we will finish the episode off, I think, by nippling us a couple of ships. And hopefully the sheeps are going to like us. Now, can I give you grass here, or are you just going to moan and whine and go, eh? Oh, you're not. Okay. How much we got left? 3,900 litters. Alrighty. Actually, I don't want to park this up. I want to take it with me. Just in case it'll let me add a little more after we actually have sheep. Because that's where we're going to go now. We have $21,000. Which is to say, we will not be buying a huge packle of sheep. That is a, what a group is called, isn't it? A packle. No? Alrighty, here we go. I love that green reflection off the chrome. It's just, I don't know. I remember when it was, even 3D Studio Max, they were, you know, which is, well, quite a high-end sort of video or rendering kind of a deal. Chrome was almost impossible. You could never get it to look like anything other than shiny plastic. Now, wow, just amazing, eh? All right, so sheep are $500. Oh, well. Yeah. We are going to buy ourselves 20 sheep. Woohoo! Rah, rah, sis, boom, bah. Look at that, guys. We have pigs, we have sheep. Man, we are farming now. Alright, any sheep in space. Now look, the reason I got you guys, I know it's the wool and everything. No, I want you to keep an eye on those freaking pigs. Thank you. Do you have water? You don't have water, do you? Alright, well, that's something I'm going to have to do. But I think as far as things goes, guys, I'm probably going to leave-a-voo the episode here. I'm just going to quickly whip over and grab the water truck. Actually, why don't we just simply have a look? Because there's a really good chance that, they have water. Yeah, we can add a little bit more grass. And a little bit more water. How's our piggies? Our piggers are doing good. Yeah, we're ready to do some water anyway, as you can see. So, wonderful. And that, I think, guys, is pretty much going to be that. I am going to tip a little bit more grass in there just to make sure they're topped up. Excellent. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, you know what to do. Hit that like button on your way out the door. And, well, it's been Species 7 for Watts Farm and Farm Sims 17. Take care of each other, folks, and ciao for now.